Hey folks, Whiskey Fox here, and today we're looking at this box. Just kidding, we're looking at what's inside the box, and as you can see, this is a nice display box. It simply lifts up. When I first got this, I guess I was under the wrong impression that it had a hinge and that it opened up like this. That would have been cool, but this is the Ray Mears logo here. And this box has a nice cloth texturing to it. Okay, and there's the inside. On the inside of the box, we have our Ray Mears Bushcraft Knife. Now, this is not the Allen Wood Woodlore Knife. This is the Stephen Wade Cox SWC Knife that Ray Mears had commissioned because of the high demand for the authentic Woodlore Knife. There is a waiting list of 10 years plus for the Allen Wood Woodlore Knife. So Ray Mears wanted people like me to be able to have access to his knife design. So he had SWC, Stephen Wade Cox, he commissioned them to make these knives. And this one I got by mail through from England. And this is the leather sheath. It's the same leather sheath you'll get with the Woodlore. The knife is basically the same. The handle, the thickness of the wood is a little bit different. But we'll go ahead and get it out. And here we go, folks. As you can see, it says SWC England. We'll go ahead and rotate the blade so you can see it. Okay, now on this side, it's going to say Ray Mears Bushcraft. This is known as the Bushcraft Knife, the Ray Mears Bushcraft Knife. Okay, again, not to be confused with the Allen Wood Woodlore Knife, but they're very, very similar. Okay, the thickness of the handle on this one, from my understanding, as you can see, it has like a hourglass shape to it. Okay, and what I really love about this knife is that it has a tapered tang, so that it is thinner here at the butt of the knife and uniform with the rest of the knife. So what that does is it creates a really excellent point of balance for the blade. And I mean, this thing is super well balanced in your hand. Okay? And it is hair popping sharp. Let's see if we can get some video of that. You can definitely hear the hairs coming up. I can see them on the edge of the blade. It is very, very sharp, folks. Okay? You do not want to play with this knife because you will get cut. This is a tool for going out in the woods and working on wood, creating furniture, making utensils to eat with, preparing firewood, cutting up your game. This is not something that you want to toy around with. And this is something you want to keep oiled, okay? And respected. The handle on this is made out of a Ruckel African hardwood. They no longer make this knife with the Ruckel wood. They've discontinued making them like this, and now they make them using oak. So the new ones have this is more of a darker color, so it's a lighter colored oak handle on the newer model. So this is one of the older models that they no longer make with this Ruckel African hardwood. I'm gonna go ahead and set the knife down real quick and pull out another knife. You might have seen this in my video recently. This is the Fullneven F1 Pilot Rescue Knife. I think it is, Pilot Rescue Knife, PRK. And I just wanted to bring it out for size comparison. Okay, not that they're you know, hugely similar, but they are very similar. There's the handle length. The bushcraft knife has a little bit more meat to the handle. And when you compare side by side, the bushcraft knife is slightly longer. Okay. And if you look at the blades, they're about the same thickness. All right. So I just wanted to show that to you real quick. And the shape of the knife is a little bit different. This one has more like a spear point edge. And of course it has the Scandi grind, which is famous for Ray Mears knife, is to see that Scandinavian grind. And over here, this has actually got a convex edge. So different grinds on the edges of the blades, but I wanted you to see how similar they were. This type of knife here is an heirloom quality knife that you would keep in your family and pass down to your children and them to their children. This is not something to take for granted. This is a very expensive piece of equipment and definitely something to be treasured and respected. And I wanted to give you a look-see at it. Okay, folks, we've got a brass here and brass loveless bolts. They call these loveless. I guess they just don't get any love. But that's about it. And we'll go ahead and sheath it on up. And call it a day. This is Whiskey Fox. Give me a thumbs up if you liked the video. Subscribe if you're not already. And please pass it along to your friends. Let them know about my channel. There's going to be some exciting changes coming up. Do appreciate you tuning in. You folks have a good night. Take care.